Hey everybody, I'm Nigh from here, and welcome back to The End is Nigh. So we're to the point now that we're... Our deaths are counting against us? So all those tumors we collected. Are gonna help us here. At least that's the plan. I think we want to wait until they're back together. Comes to be close. Yeah. So that's a big no. Oh, Jesus. Okay, so we gotta go. Oh, gosh. Yeah. Oh, come on. Okay, I gotta drop down. I think I gotta get up. There's something all the way up there, but I don't know how you get there. Nah, I was so close. Damn it. You're kidding me. Nope. I'm spending too much time in the air. I'm gonna lose a lot of lives here. Wow. Excuse me? Okay, you can't jump over that. Okay, I think I see the point. Nope, that was way too late. Okay, that's definitely... I'm getting upset. I wonder if this is actually doable the way that I'm trying to do it. Gotta wait longer. I don't know why I'm going earlier. So that shouldn't be that hard. Then I can just be bad. Wow, that was bad. Okay, I was expecting that to fall. Really? Yikes. Oh, gosh darn it. Why I tried to destroy as little as possible. I feel like there's probably certain ones that I need to destroy. Oh gosh. Okay. So I have to destroy... that one. That one. Shoot. I'm just being bad. Why did I fall right off the edge there? That's the part that bugs me, is like, I was intending to step on the one and land on the other. Okay, that worked. God damn it. Come on. I'm a little upset. So I think you have to... Come on, game. I'm not sure you can make that jump. Well, clearly you can, because I did, but it didn't look like you could. Well, fuck you too. Okay, I figured that wouldn't work, but... No, I want to hit and bounce. Okay, that felt promising. Nope. I think that was as tight as I could honestly get it. I don't think there's really a mid-jump here that I can actually pull off. Yep, it's not really gonna do it. Alright. It's the mid jumps. I really just don't enjoy mid jumps. I don't think the skill that is required for them is valuable. Gotta send that one a lot more, it seems. For that. Well, I have done this incorrectly, and I don't think I can get back up, so you gotta stay high. We're done. Getting crushed is... Yeah, no, we're done. We didn't stay high enough. Yeah, didn't stay high enough. Like, there's a little bit of leeway. Nope. I just got spiked. So the pattern stays the same, I do believe, so... Glad I decided to bail out of that at the right moment. I need to time the middle section, it seems. Barely got that. I didn't think I was gonna make that. Oh, well, hello. I already don't like this. The fact that there's some places, like, I just want to, like, crawl up over the edge. I got spiked by that. I got spiked again. I'm a little upset. Yay, I'm screwed. I'm gonna run out of lives, 100%. Guarantee. I don't know how much further we have to go, but... yeah, that's a death. Come on, you son of a bitch. No. Stop it. I couldn't bail out of that lightly. And I was gonna be screwed there anyway, because he was just, he was already there. I didn't grab on. I'm trying to skip this part, because I don't think it's a good... come on, I was on it! I was on it and I wasn't pressing any buttons. I almost get out of that. Yeah. I actually think I don't want to ever touch that one. I think I want to go straight over. Well, that got in my way. No, the transition in between those two is bad. Jesus. Do these? I like these. More than other stuff. Oh, yeah, whoops. That one's traversal time is so long. It completely ignored it. Damn. The slightly falling off the edge thing is just infuriating. Because I've stopped putting inputs into the controller, and that's when it decides that it's time for me to die. How do I avoid that? I don't know. Avoidance of monsters that have set AI, like, to a degree is a puzzle, and to a degree is just obnoxious. Ah. Oh, okay, well, that's a thing. Alright, so it's just like... these are stationary. I am not happy about that. Fuck you. Yeah, like, go to sleep for a brief bit. And that's what you have to exploit? Oh no. That was really close. Yeah, see, this is the... The island is so small that you have to get it on your first go, or you will immediately die. Oh, goodness. This is a weird one. A cup! Of course that's what she did. I fucking hate so much of this. Of course I can't actually clear that. I had to try. I figured, based on the rest of the level design, that you, in fact, could not. Come on. What? Fuck off, game. What? No, hit detection, fucking please. Like, I'm barely doing that. Oh, I see it. Barely, but I see it. Oh, there's spikes. Yeah, damn it. Of course there's spikes there. Okay, the ones with cracked skulls disappear after the use. I hadn't noticed that was a difference in them before. Fuck, you have to be holding A after that point. Trying to... correct... That's one of the stationary ones, too. Come on. Get to the crux of why. Just want to play different games. I just wanted to get off. I just want to get off Mr. Bone's Wild Ride. Like, I just suddenly disappeared into the fucking sky. Sure. Since apparently that works. Fuck. I did not want to do that, but okay. Don't care how it worked. Oh, I almost got over that. Ugh, you have to like go past and then back. I couldn't jump fast enough after that. Come now, I jumped. Oh, I hate everything about this. Explain, I want someone to explain to me how I didn't grab onto that one. Cause I should have. Just one out. That too. Like, there's definitely more optimal ways through this that I am taking, but okay, we have frogs now. I hate the frogs so much. Somebody want to explain to me how I did the thing that I am pretty much 100% certain I'm supposed to do. Okay, that one I shorted because you have to short it, but I shorted it too much. Okay, I'm just gonna go with disagree. Yep. Didn't short that one enough. game. That one I was just 100% yeeted. Fuck. I just wanted to gently jump off that, but no. What? I didn't grab the hook. I think that's about 95% of my complaints about this game is not grabbing ledges when you're supposed to grab ledges. And we're in the right place to grab ledges, but didn't. Okay. They didn't do that before, but now they do. Don't care enough anymore. Fuck you, little flying sausage ball. Right, because he sleeps. Yep, that's about how I feel. Ooh, fuck you, spike in the corner, because of course there's a spike in the corner. Need to go eat dinner. Oh, I'm playing this. Oh wow, we're already at 36 minutes. So here's what I'm doing. Anguish, gloom, blight, ruin, acceptance. Nevermore. I I don't... Anguish, gloom... I just don't care. And... I hate that I don't care, but I'm kind of done with this game. So... I think I'm just calling it. I don't think the game's bad, it's just not a game that I care for. Like, I was having fun through the early stuff, and there were some neat things in there, but... And I've said this about platformers in general, I'm not good at them. Like, I'm not bad either, like, clearly I can do some things, but... I feel like I'm fighting the mechanics of the game more than I'm enjoying the mechanics of the game. And... while I think there's a lot of interesting stuff here, I would rather be playing something else. And I think that's the crux of it, is when it comes to platformers, they don't hold me. They just don't hold me. Like, you know, when I was a kid and I played Super Mario, the Super Mario Brothers, you know, I played 1, I played 2, I played 3. I didn't actually play Super Mario World. We jumped straight from NES to N64. We didn't do a Super Nintendo in the middle. I missed out on a bunch of cool games, but like, I don't know. The only way I ever played the original Mario was by skipping a whole bunch of levels. Like, that's pretty much the only way I ever played it. But Mario, I don't know. Mario's really not a... It's really only a platforming game, but it's not a very complicated one. It's a very simple one. 2 is just fucking weird, but that's obviously because we didn't have the lost levels, or you know, they were deemed too hard for the US, or whatever the actual truth behind that one is. But I don't know, like, the end is nigh. Like, I had some fun with some of the challenges, but in the end, at the end of the day, at the end of the day, there are ways for me to determine whether or not I'm enjoying a game. And, like, it's the small things. It's not necessarily that I'm not enjoying my time explicitly playing the game. Like, I'm having fun. Like, every single time you finish a level, you get a little bit of that, you know, that catharsis of, I finished it, yes. Like, that is clearly a thing that happens. But it's like, if, you know, every single time you're trying to do something, it's more of like an instinctual reaction, right? Like, if you've got a dog or a cat or a pet or something, and they don't want to do something, they don't like doing something, or you notice that every single time you do something, they react in the same way. Like, I think the best example was like, the best example, it's Pavlovian response, right? It's the ring a bell, the dog starts drooling. But it doesn't necessarily, like, you don't have to understand why you're having that response. Like, the dog doesn't necessarily understand that, oh, I heard the bell, I'm going to get food, I'm going to start drooling. Like, that may be the logical following of those events. Like, that is what trained that dog. And that's why it has that response, but it doesn't necessarily need to be consciously going through that response. For me, games that I don't enjoy, I don't have backlog on. Like, I'm recording this on the 20th. Like, late on the 20th. I'm probably going to upload it the night before. Or like, on the morning of that I'm going to be releasing it. And that's because I don't have backlog for those games, because if I have a choice, if I sit down at my computer and I, you know, maybe it's Monday, I've just released the last episode, and I go, hey, what can I play? Well, I'm already good on Dicey Dungeons, I'm already good on Stardew Valley Until the End of the Universe. What do I want to play? Like, I don't have anything coming out for the next 3 days. I can play whatever I want to do, or like, I don't have to record anything that's coming out in the next 3 days. What do I want to do? What do I want to play? What game am I going to? It's never the end is nigh. The only time I have backlog on the end is Nigh is when I record like for an hour and a half on accident because I'm just grinding something and I'm losing track of time. That's pretty much the only time I have backlog in this game. And it's because I'm putting off when I want to play it. That is the Pavlovian response. I don't particularly enjoy this game, at least the same way that I do other games I could be playing. So the question I ask myself is, why am I playing? And the answer is, maybe I'd like to finish it. Like, yeah, I'd kind of like to finish it, but I'm not going to go in 100% this game. And it, you know, if somebody asked me if I've played The End is Nigh and I go, yeah, I played it, I didn't really finish it, but it was okay. Like, if that person's going to be like, oh, you didn't finish the game, what are you doing? You're wasting your time. I'll just be like, yeah, I didn't enjoy it. Like, I tried it, I played it for a while, and then I stopped enjoying it, so I stopped playing it. And that is a entirely reasonable response to a game. Entirely reasonable. So yeah, I'm gonna not play the game anymore. Maybe I'll come back to it someday, but probably not. I'll be honest. I'm not gonna uninstall it or anything. I've got enough room on my games drive, but yeah, I don't have a particular desire. Just don't. So yeah, I think we're going to call this one the finale. It's a little bit underwhelming, sure, but I want to play some fucking Monster Train, dude. Like, I picked that up when it was on sale. I played it a couple times, so I've got, like, a couple episodes of backlog already, but I would love to feel like I'm allowed to play it because I'm releasing for it. I guess Receiver 2 is also on the table since we're working through the bundle for racial justice and equality on Sundays. Maybe, you know what, maybe I make Sunday the finishing up of those, because I'm doing an intro there, and the games that I want to play more of, maybe I just finish on Sunday. I like that idea, because I do want to finish Golf Peaks, and I do kind of want to finish Fossil Hunters, and the next game that's coming out this weekend, I've actually already finished. It's not a terribly long game, but it was very addictive. So I think that's what we're going to do, and I think that's going to be overall better for me. I would argue better for the channel, but that's a different issue. I don't know. I don't think many people are watching The End is Nigh. I don't know. I guess if you are watching this and you really, 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 really want me to finish it, maybe I'll consider it if you leave a comment, but that's not a guarantee. I think that you will probably find more enjoyment watching like a speedrunner play it because they have practiced it so much and they will kick its ass. And I think that's part of the things about platformers is the skills, and I've mentioned this in previous episodes of this, is the skills required to be good at platforming are you pretty unique to platforming. And on top of that, aren't skills that I find valuable. The mid-jump is the key to this. Because you can tap A, just a millisecond, for a jump. Or you can hold it, which is, you know, get as high as you can. And anywhere in the middle, you now must hold the button for an arbitrary amount of time. And to me, that's not fun. That's not a skill I care to develop, right? Like, if tapping an A is holding it for 0 seconds, and doing a full jump is holding it for one, you know, this mid jump is a 0.3 seconds. This one's a 0.6 seconds. That one's a 0.7 seconds. That's I don't know. It just feels tedious and annoying. I don't know. It like being able to time that on a controller is not something that I find valuable being able to do. So that is what a lot of this last section was, as well as honestly the mechanics for grabbing on to not edges, grabbing onto, well, not like like the whole holding down the trigger and walking off the edge causes you to grab onto it. That was good. I liked that. I think that was very good. But holding on to like the little hooks on the wall and catching corners from a jump honestly, it feels like there's some bad code there. It really feels like there's some bad code. Like, it feels like there could at least be an extra button that's like a please try and catch things button. I don't want it to be like a forced mechanic, like you must press this button to grab stuff, but like something that like increases the radius that you can grab. But that doesn't work because then you'll have to do it because they'll create sections that you have to use that in. It's just, it feels like there are times where it's like, yes, I'm clearly going to grab this, and then I didn't. Or, I need to be pressed up against that wall to grab that thing. But if I press up against the wall, I'll hit those spikes. So I need to wait until the exact split second that I'm next to that to hit right just a little bit so that I'll just catch the hook but don't hit the spike. Like, that, we're already at too much. We're already at too much at that point. And I think that's just kind of how I feel about most of the high-tech platformers, is that they're just asking for too much button input, too much precision, that me as a gamer doesn't find valuable. I'm very curious to see how Celeste goes, because I'm going to play that at some point, and I know that's a high-tech platformer, but I don't think it's quite this meticulous. I don't know. I think it makes better use of its mechanics, because I think, I don't know, the end is nigh, I kind of ran out of mechanics a while ago. I don't know. I feel like I haven't seen anything new in the game for a while. I guess the little levitation things were new, but those felt boring. I don't know. Maybe that's just me. Either way, this is going to be... My final word on the end is nigh is, I think it's a good platformer if you like platformers. I have some problems with it and with platformers in general. If you like platformers, I think you like it. If you don't, I don't think you will. And if you're on the fence about platformers, it's going to depend on how much precision you like in your games. So, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. We'll be back next week with something new. I haven't decided quite yet, but we'll figure it out. But yeah, until then, keep your gears turning.